Hello everyone, welcome back to Eric Sifo and Watson. Today we are going to have a review against the Remora aluminum suitcase. This suitcase is previously called Classic Flight, but recently it's been rebranded as a Classic Cabin. This suitcase I bought it in year 2014, and I've been using it for 10 years. So after viewing this video, you expect that if you buy the suitcase this year, what will happen to the suitcase after 10 years? This is a small compact suitcase which you can carry on board the flight. For the last 10 years, normally I travel 3 to 4 times a year overseas, staying 4 to 5 days each time. I carried it on board with me, except for a few occasions when I check in counter. So I've been using it for more than 30 overseas trips. Every time I pull it, push it, open it, close it, unlock it, and so on. And it's still alive. Before we move forward, let me introduce my channel, Eric Sifo and Watson, to you guys. This channel covers various topics for big boys. Not limited to tech and reviews, but also map modification, Chinese lantern, jeans, and denim jacket, RC cars and boats, and Holy Land tour. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you like my channel, please subscribe and tap the bell button so that you'll be notified when a new video comes up. 10 years ago when I bought this Remora suitcase, it was around $750, but this year the selling price has already been increased to $1,450. The price increased a lot over the last decade. It was partly due to the rise of the aluminum price over the last 10 years, but also the pricing strategy of Remora playing an important part of the price increase. It tends to have an increment year by year, so that over a long period of time, there's a huge increase in selling price. The advantage of this is that people who bought it will be very happy because the price increases over time. But the disadvantage is that the newcomers will have some hesitation in buying because the entry price is so high. But if we look into the reselling price on eBay, we find that for this suitcase, the reselling price range from $700 to $1,100. That means if I were going to sell this suitcase right now, probably I will get a profit. Now let's have a closer look on the suitcase. It's made by aluminium, very shiny, and is rectangular shape. We are going to look into it side by side first, and this side with the TSA lock. The suitcase is opened by dragging the lock button apart. When we drag it, the lock will pump up. If we want to reset the password, it's easy. Instead of dragging the button apart, we push the button towards the number rollers so that we can reset the password. On the same side, there is a leather handle which is still in excellent condition despite being used for 10 years. The same leather handle could be found on the top of the suitcase with a leather tag attached to it. The four corners of the suitcase has been further reinforced by metal, but there is dent and scratches over them. On the other side of the suitcase, there are four rubber pads which have some dirt and scratches, and also three hinges. compared with other brands of luggages that only have two hinges. Remova provide stronger protection for long-term use. Now let's have a look over the side of the wheels are. The luggage wheels are amazingly smooth, even though it's been used for 10 years. It's because there are ball bearings inside and telescopic handles still work great. After opening the suitcase, there is plenty of space inside. Now I'm going to put the clothes for a 5-day trip into it to see how many space it takes up. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yep. 4 socks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 pair of jeans, and 1 outer coat, excluding the underpants. Just taken up half of the suitcase, so you still have half of the suitcase for the souvenir and so on. Why does Eric like this Remora Classic suitcase? First of all, the suitcase itself is very durable, despite it has dents and scratches from many trips over the years. Yet, the overall condition is still very good. No damage of any kind is found, and the interior space is large enough to suit any short trips. Secondly, if you buy Remova, you are buying a piece of history. Remova has been making aluminium suitcase since the year 1937, when a fire happened in the factory, which destroys almost everything except aluminium. It was the first aluminium suitcase manufacturer. As you can see that the competitors are making aluminium suitcases, but you know, they learn from Remora, so that the differences between Remora and other brands narrowing down. But remember, Remora is always the original, which deserves a premium. Apart from that, there is a reselling value of Remora suitcases. As I mentioned earlier, the reselling price of Remora stays high. If you put it for sale on eBay, you probably have a chance to get a profit. To be honest, it's really hard for me to cite anything which could be reselling at a higher price after usage of a long time. Even iPhone couldn't do that. If you bought an iPhone 6 or 7 in year 2014, what would happen to its value in 2024? Probably it'll be resold at a price of $20 to $30. If it still works, for other suitcases manufacturer who also make aluminium suitcases, does they have the same reselling value compared with Remora suitcases? Probably not. Another reason why I like it is the after sale warranty. It's no doubt that it's very durable, but in case if it really damaged it during your voyage, your suitcase is lifetime ruined. You can easily find a store in any country which could fix your problem, and you can continue your voyage. For other brands, I could not tell if they could beat Remora on this aspect. Even so, will they still be there after decades? The last reason is very personal for me. I like Remora suitcases because I like putting stickers onto the luggage. Wherever I go, I would go to souvenir stores searching for stickers and put it on the suitcase. The benefit of this is that I can easily identify it on the belt. Also, it gives me a memory of the places I've been visited. But honestly, not all suitcases could hold the stickers for a long time, as many of them has just met service. If you consider it with
Remora's sovereignty, you will not hard to understand why Remora has an edge over others. If you got your luggage damaged on any parts, you could have it replaced because Remora has been making these same suitcases for many years. For other planes, if you could not repair it, and if you are not able to transplant the sticker to a new one, you have to restart your collection over. But there is also a disadvantage of this suitcase. For the weight of this suitcase I'm showing to you is 3.2 kg, but for the latest version of the same model is 4.2 kg, which increases a lot. As many airlines has a restriction on carry-on baggages, you need to consider this very carefully before you buy. For the larger size of the same model is just 6 kg, which is relatively lighter compared with the size it has. If you ask me whether to buy this suitcase or not, my opinion is, why not? There's nothing you lose it. Historical data has proven that the value of it is increasing over time. And after many years of usage, you can resell it even for profit. If you use other brands which are cheaper or less durable, probably you will use $200 to $300 over 10 years. Also, Remora has solid warranty service, has very good quality, so I don't see why you guys keep trying using other brands if there is already the best one in the market. Today, our topic ends here. If you have any questions or concern, please feel free to leave a message. Remember, like, subscribe, and share. See you next time.